The City of Nanaimo came to us in about 2000. We worked on a smaller project with the water park. And then about 2005, they came and said, what would you guys like in this area? And we'd always talked about a skate park.
Essentially, it started with Peggy. Peggy confronted Chris at Island Riders. And at that time, Chris was running the Nanaimo Skateboard Association. And she was kind of had the passion and the vision for it. And then Chris and I jumped in and started fundraising and promoting it as much as we could. And then it kind of just grew from there.
The city has been focusing on this area and this park for some time. This, for me, represents revitalization, but also a recognition of the importance of healthy recreation for everyone. I'm extremely grateful for the contribution of Mid-Island Consumer Services Cooperative. Having been on the board way back when and appreciating the co-op literally started in Harewood, to see this contribution and giving back to the community is a wonderful thing.
The whole purpose of this park was accommodating everything that hasn't been accommodated in previous parks before. So everything here is different than what is currently on Vancouver Island.
This isn't just a concrete slab. This is a very special kind of concrete with a lot of design components to it that make it more difficult. This isn't like laying a patio in your backyard.
We wanted it to be made for four-year-olds to ride their bike and some elite athletes that could come and do some great competitions here.
The skateboard park itself, as we know, is a world-class facility. It will literally bring people to this community to try it out who wouldn't otherwise be tourists or spending their dollars here in Nanaimo.
So far, I've seen guys from all the way out, Saskatoon, Montreal out here so far. A lot of guys from Vancouver coming over, which is huge. Pros from all over Canada are making their way here.
While the skate park was reaching its final stages, we began speaking with the City of Nanaimo about an exhibition we're holding called Border X. The city suggested that we commission some artists to do art on the skate park as part of the launch. We met with Hul'qumi'num, Gary Manson, to talk about this place and what this place means to the Nanaimo people.
They wanted me to meet with the artists in order to kind of give them an idea about culture and what things meant to us, the salmon and what this river, where this park is sitting on, what it meant to our people.
From there, Gary suggested some Hul'qumi'num that could be incorporated.
So they came up with this one word that would kind of describe a place where children play. So Hul'qumi'num is a word for smile.
The artwork responds to both this particular location, being next to the Chase River, and also to the idea of a rite of passage or cycles of life. For example, the salmon that flow through the river are speaking about this idea of the life cycle of a salmon, which also refers to rites of passage in people's lives. It's also just about joy. These figures are skateboarding and having so much fun, and then the skateboarders are having so much fun skateboarding on the skateboarders. So this work has been so well received by the skateboarding community, which has also been a really rewarding thing to see.
I thank the gallery for this effort, and they're always thinking about our First Nations people whenever they do work in the community, and very honored that they include us.
Honestly, it was kind of emotional once it was finished. I had a hard time skating it. Yeah, when it was finally done, it was pretty hard to believe, but seeing it packed every day is great.
Having this park in this neighborhood is offering a place to belong for so many young people.
It's just exactly what we had thought about, so it's like a dream come true.
When you have a place like this for everyone to gather, this is what builds and maintains a healthy community.